nyo. Marami kayong matututuhan dito, marami malalaman. Father Ken Felician po. At lahat po ng viewers niya mong binabati kayo ng aking bangs.
Hello. Masan yung Paris mo?
Ako yung taga Victoria po. Victoria. Pasyal kayo doon. Matanda na po yung parokya namin. Founded in the year is 1771.
Oh,
kaya po this year, si-celebrate kami ng 250 founding years anniversary.
Oh.
Ini-invite ko po kayo lahat.
Malapit na yun, man.
December 8 po.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Sa lahat po ng viewers, parishioners po, ito po ay panalangin para sa lahat. Mag-isa po kayo sa banal na misa.
So that we can have a better view whenever we make something using our cameras.
Ilang segundo na lamang po magsisimula na yung misa.
Father Nixon and Father Jeffrey Rizon, please come up the sanctuary.
Hello and welcome po sa Diocese of Tarlac. Pray for all the priests as we conclude our annual clergy retreat today. Thank you for all the prayers and thank you for the support po natin sa ating mga parokya. We will be undergoing the synodal process. Sana po makiisa tayo sa paglalakbay ng simbahang nakikinig. Magandang araw po.
Sasama po namin kayo sa misa ngayong araw, ngayong oras na ito. And let us also pray for the victims of pandemic, and let us pray for the souls of Linda, Flora, Da, Jesus, Julieta, Ifeme, Baby Jim, Chopilo, all for souls in purgatory. Thanksgiving Mass from Santos, Pineda, and Lobo families.
Celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Son, of you, the Godfather of our Lord of mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ of mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord of mercy.
Lord of mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God who in the highest.
The word of the Lord.
gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in distress. Therefore, we fear not, though the earth be shaken, and mountains plunge into the depths of the sea.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
There is his children whose brothers gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is in his peace. It shall not be disturbed. God will help him at the break of dawn.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. Come, behold the deeds of the Lord, the astounding things he has wrought on earth.
The waters of the rivers gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
We read from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, you are God's building, according to the grace of God given to me. Like a wise master builder, I lay the foundation, and another is building upon it. But each one must be careful how he builds upon it. For no one lay a foundation other than the one that is there, namely Jesus Christ. Do you not know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person, for the temple of God, which you are, is holy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus Christ. movement towards what lies ahead. And I think the message of our readings today speak of what is God's role in our lives as priests, as a presbyterium, as God's church. Very powerful is the image in our first reading from the book of Ezekiel. Living waters flowing from different fonts and giving life to the temple. We look at that image from the vantage point of the New Testament, and we understand that it is actually the Spirit of God giving life to the church. Obviously, the Holy Spirit has been very much present during these 2 days. And I believe even onwards. The Spirit has many ways to work in us. Through prayer, reflection, perhaps many things were triggered in our hearts to look at ourselves, to look at our relationships with the bishop, with each other, with our parishioners. That's how the Holy Spirit works. The Holy Spirit would hit us in many ways. But I think if there is one challenge that the gospel tells us very clearly, is let us not desecrate the work of the Spirit. Let us build from what the Spirit has done, does, and continues to do to us. Let me be specific. First, let us not desecrate the Spirit in us, in our own person, in our own priesthood. Very clear, Jesus talked about the Spirit in the temple of his body. We look at our lives and we know when we were baptized, we already received the Holy Spirit and gained this gift of common sonship. Because of that Spirit, we are able to call God Abba Father. Because of that Spirit, as they say, even in the rite of baptism, we are living temples of God. This Spirit hovers and lingers when they receive the gift of ordination. When the bishop imposes hands on us. The gift, the grace is there. But let it not be desecrated by our own sinfulness, by our sinful actions that destroy our human personhood and our own priesthood. You know what I mean. Kung meron po sigurong talagang natanggap natin sa retreat na ito, napagtilayan natin yung buhay natin, yung pagkapari natin, yung mga pagkukulang natin, yung pagkakasala natin. At tayo naman po nag-decision, pwede kakasala, tayo din ay sumisira sa sarili natin, pagkataon natin, tsaka pagkapari natin. Second, I think the Lord also was talking of the Spirit in the community of disciples. Paul was very clear in our second reading. The Spirit in the temple of Ecclesia. But the Ecclesia starts, as we try to look at it, from one perspective in the Presbyterium. We see here the body of Christ. But what do we see here? And how will the Spirit work? We know that as a Presbyterium, as we have been gifted with this identity, as I was sharing, our sacramental brotherhood, we also understand that we have not and we will never be spared from hurts in the Presbyterium. But who inflicts hurt? We do. Papag-isa sa atin. Sa ating Presbyterium, nasasaktan natin ang bawat isa kapag meron po tayong sinasabi ng kasinuhan nila. Pag naninirang pura tayo sa bawat isa. Pag alam naman natin ang totoo, pero ibinabaling natin na para pagang totoo, pero alam natin kasinuhan nila. Kung inuhusgahan natin ang ating kapwa-pari, at nakikita naman natin na ito'y pananaw lang at hindi kabuuan. Tayo. Tayo. Ang dumede sakra sa katawan ni Kristo sa ating komunidad bilang pari. The Holy Spirit is there. But we ask ourselves, how can we make the Spirit work so that we become healers? We bind up wounds. We bridge gaps. We have the energy to listen to each other, to reach out to one another, to love everyone. No exclusivity, everyone inclusive. Kaya alam niyo, malimitan, kayo po galing sa seminaryo at ako'y naging formator ng napakadaming taon at naging chair po ako ng commission at seminaries ng walong taon. Ako na po ang magsasabi sa inyo sa aking pakikipag-usap at fora sa mga seminarista. Yung kanilang anxiety, yung kanilang fear, ang tinuturo sa seminaryo, unity of the Presbyterium, pero papasok ako sa disunited Presbyterium. Presbyterium na may mga faction-faction. Finally, let's talk about the whole church, or your particular church, or your parish community. That is where the Spirit works. And very critical in understanding how we can cooperate with the work of the Spirit is that we allow the Spirit to blend us. We allow the Spirit to mold us. We allow the Spirit to act when we find it difficult to act and make our Christian community one. Alam niyo po yan, isa lang magsalita din sa isang mandated organization. o mahalin ka sa iba, kumusta? We all have contributed, and I'm saying including me, to the desecration of God's temple in the community, human as we are. That's why when the Lord was filled with wrath, we could then understand why He lashed all these people who desecrated His Father's house. Because He knew how sacred that was. If you can just greet each other knowing that the other person before you is sacred, that the community of disciples, the Presbyterian, is sacred, that the church you have, whether it is diocese or the particular community of the parish, is sacred, we will be manifesting the love of God. We will be manifesting what it means to be a sinful church. Here's the last point. Perhaps you will tell me, mahirap yun, Bishop. Parang ngayon, hindi ko kaya yan. May pinadaanan ako, Bishop. Hirap ako makitungo sa ilang parishioner ko o ilang pari ko, nagiging ko ng pakataas na hindi na makababa. O kaya sa aming Bishop.
Basilica is the cathedral of the Bishop of Rome. Let us pray for the intention of the Pope for precise charity over the people of God. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Church appear before men and women as Christ bride, adored by faithfulness, good works, and perseverance. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Holy Father, the Pope, become the visible center and foundation of our unity in faith and love. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we become the living temple of the Holy Spirit that offers to God spiritual worship through a life of holiness. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Holy Spirit endow the Church with His seven gifts for the building up of the body of Christ, until all the faithful come to the unity of faith and knowledge of the Son of God. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the church building, which is called the house of the Father, open its door to those without strength, light, and consolation, that they may find refuge in the friendship of Christ. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, may the visible house of prayer remind us that we are the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit. May we honor the divine dwelling through a life acceptable to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. by sending God your Spirit upon them like a newborn, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. This will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be holy heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you. Your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may always flee from sin and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, for even reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
In your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Love of God and gracious of the
peace,
world,
peace,
mercy
peace,
on us. Love of God and gracious of the world, have mercy on us. Love of God and gracious of the world, grant us peace.
Thank you.
Chose to foreshadow for us the heavenly Jerusalem through the sight of your church on earth. God, we pray that by our partaking of this sacrament, may we be the temple of your grace and may enter the dwelling place of your glory through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Be seated.
Isang pinagbalang hapon po sa ating lahat. Sa pangungunan ng Commission on Clergy, nais nating kilalanin at magbigay pugay sa dalawang pari na nagdiwang ng kanilang 25th taon sa pagkapari ngayong taong ito. Supposed to be po apat sila, pero ang isa ay pumanaw na around 6 or 7 years ago, si Reverend Father Romeo Despacio. At yung isa po, nauna namin ibinigay na. Simple token lang po. Diocese of Tarlac, plaque of recognition is given to Reverend Father Andres P. Paragas Jr., ordained priest on September 7, 1996. And Reverend Father Manolito G. Santos, ordained priest on September 14, 1996. Your 25 years of faithful service has been a generous gift to a world in need. May the Lord bless you as you have blessed so many and give you peace and joy in your priestly ministry. May the God of hope fill you with joy and peace. With gratitude for your devotion from your diocese, even this ninth day of November in the year of our Lord 2021 at San Sebastian Cathedral, Tarlac City. Signed, Most Reverend Enrique V. Macarele, D.D., Bishop of Tarlac. Tatanggap din po sila ng imahen ng ating patron, si St. John Mary Vianney.
Of the Presbyterium of the Diocese of Tarlac, let me express our sincere thanks and gratitude to His Excellency Bishop Paolo Vergara for facilitating our annual clergy retreat. But Bishop Paolo, thank you for sharing with us your insights and thoughts on the nature of our priesthood, especially during this time of pandemic COVID-19. Thank you for enlightening us of the true identity of a priest, which is the idea that we must all strive to emulate. And thank you for talking about the topic on stewardship, which is the concern and the desire of the Catholic Bishops' Conference to be implemented in our dioceses. Actually, we started this stewardship years ago when we tried to implement the computerized system of financial finances in the parishes, and which we are hoping to attain this coming months, which will eventually lead to our desire to have the standard compensation of our clergy, and of course to implement the program of stewardship, which is being pushed by the CDCP in our parishes to embrace this spirituality of stewardship to make it as our way of life. So Bishop Milo, thank you very much, and we wish you all the best in all your endeavors, and please pray for us, the clergy, the Presbyterium of the Diocese of Tarlac.
Have happened at a more opportune time as we grapple not only with the challenges of the pandemic, but on how we as pastors and shepherds spiritually lead our people through the labyrinth of moral, mental, medical, economic, and political issues that face our particular communities. The lessons you gave on priestly stewardship and mission in these most challenging times of the pandemic are inspiring, informative, spiritually enriching, and are memorable enough for us to keep returning to when we need input and wisdom, both in our search for life's meaning and in our exercise of pastoral governance in our parishes. The guiding questions for discussions, interactions, and reflections you handed us made us not only better persons, but bonded us as better brothers to one another in the one priesthood of Christ. And some of us entered this retreat weak and breaking, our sessions and exercises refreshed and rejuvenated us. They helped tie much the loose ends in our ministry. Now thank you for helping us realize the Jerusalems and Moses, the Galilees of our priesthood. Thank you for teaching us to grieve, to squarely face our guilt, and to always believe in grace. And thank you for making us re-evaluate our priorities in our ministry and renew our commitment to the mission. And thank you for reminding us that in the work of building the body of Christ, we have to respect and then desecrate the work and temple of the Holy Spirit in us. In everything we do, we have to follow the promptings not of the flesh, but of the Holy Spirit. Thank you for becoming our Father and brother, even for just these 2 brief days. We have witnessed in you the pastoral charity of Christ, our Good Shepherd, through your Episcopal motto, Pace Agnus Meus, feed my lambs. You have fed us like lambs, and we are blessed. And I tell you, our clerical colors no longer show. Now, dear Bishop, please accept our humble token and gift as our way of saying, in the name of our Bishop Enrique Macaraeg and the clergy, of the Diocese of Tarlac, our tokens and gifts. Salamat po ng maraming sa inyo. God bless you.
Senior
clergy, for the rest of those who belong to other brackets, please be seated. At the end of the other brackets, or all the other brackets, we shall have a